various governments, local bodies, startups. So I'm very happy to share my experiences with her and trying to understand how government is innovating. So from all these angles, I have made a small presentation, and this is the structure. So we'll talk about innovation, then the application of innovation in e-governance space, particularly examples from our own government, Government of Telangana. Then shortly introducing what do we do, so that when we, you people go back, those who are not associated with us can understand us better. And finally, some 5 to 7 minutes we can spend on question answers. Now coming to the innovation, so just would like to share with you how many people you have read today's I think cover story, I don't know. It's about, it is called X-59. Anybody? No. X-59 is developed by NASA, and it is not a spacecraft. It is not a spacecraft, it is a jet which will carry passengers, but it will in 3 hours. Can you believe? 3 hours, which will take normally 5.5 to 6 hours. It's called a supersonic engine. But what is the point? The point is the innovation which they are trying to improve. Supersonic jets are there, Concorde has done it earlier. But what is this NASA has done? It took them 30 years. So I just want to emphasize the point. Sometimes innovations take so long, and some people ask, what is the difference between innovation and then, you know, the original invention? Maybe nowadays they are very thin difference, but let me share with you that most of the startups, they are all are starting, particularly in Hyderabad and Telangana, they are all innovators. They are having, if you see here, we are talking about idea and action. That's what come out, or maybe the original inventions as such, but a small step is always innovative. So that is the point. Today this summit is organized on innovation. So I would like to say there are some definitions. Of course, the definition has come also from the National Knowledge Commission and also from the OECD. But let us not go deep in definition. What it means is, it means basically the process or product. Can you add some value? Can you add some incremental value is also okay. That is what innovation is. So maybe all of you are having some ideas, but the ideas are with you. If you take a baby step, it may lead to innovation. That's it. The innovation is as simple as that. It is nothing kind of jargon or something to, you know, deep thinking. Many of the apps which are being launched on Android, I believe there are about 10 to 20,000 apps are being launched on Android platform every day. Most of them are very innovative. If you see that, small idea, take action. There's innovation. Now, you'll be happy to know, I'm very proud that Telangana is now, if you see in this index also developed by Government of India, Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog says, now who is innovative? They have some parameters, and on those parameters they have just the states. The innovation in the state governments. Which state government is aggressive? And they found that Telangana is having on number 4 in this list. I'm very sure we'll reach the places higher by our hard work in various state government departments and corporations, organizations. We are very happy to associate with most of the organizations here and improve on this innovation index. So just wanted to introduce that there is a measurement also is there, whether you are innovative or not, you may say, but government is measuring. Going forward, let us, I would like to share about what is the innovation in e-governance space. We are talking about improving transparency, dissemination of information, improving administrative efficiency in public service. That's what the e-governance, m-governance is. And I just want to share one, my personal example, what happened in this case. All of you are aware about immunization. I think the people sitting here definitely must have taken at least couple of shots when you are babies. Am I right? The immunization shots about the 6 deadly diseases and all might not be even aware your father, mother might have ensured that. So this e-immunization solution, I'll just want to share the experience how it has developed. As all of you are knowing, this is immunization is about preventive cure. It is not about the, you know, when you have a problem, you don't go, like you go to doctor, you are very keen to go and nowadays whole body checkup and everything. But when it comes to prevention of any disease, our country and our thinking is very bad. And that reflects in this immunization program. This is going on for last maybe 60-70 years, but there is no remarkable improvement. And why? The basically philosophies of prevention, we don't give value. Number two, we don't have proper mechanism for implementation of this immunization program. Why I'm saying so is the immunization people think as a first shot when you give the first vaccine and that's it. And that is now, I'm very happy to share, 90% of the people are getting the first vaccine. But what happens to second, third, fourth? It is a matrix of about 18 months. And 18 months, nobody follows it up. So this solution, I incubated this idea way back in 2003. I went to Stanford University and then developed this completely, tested in Khammam when there I was collector there. And I have shown that it is possible to improve the immunization to IT technology. Simple thing, track for every kind of shot, give a receipt to the maybe illiterate father, mother, parents, you give that and they will definitely come for their welfare of their kins next time. The small intervention through IT and giving a small receipt, like a kirana shop, grocery shop, you go and they give a small receipt, or you go now in supermarkets like that. All the short matrix has been captured in the, now we'll talk about cloud. That time we were not thinking about cloud. Cloud was not in existence then. Similarly, in my district, Khammam, we used to have a lot of accidents. Then that was 2004, I am narrating the story. Now you are familiar with 108, right? 108 ambulance service, everybody knows what it is. It is in, at least in our country, most of the states this 108 has reached. Way back there was no 108, and I have this idea of pulling up the ambulance services. If one ambulance, you will be surprised to know that these reasons for which not getting the ambulance service is like, no, there is no air in the tire, the driver is on leave, or some minor repairs is there. Some or the other reason, we will not get that thing and then we can't blame the system. So what was the alternative? I was thinking, remaining within government framework, I pulled up the ambulances in the adjoining regions and made a backup arrangement. If first doesn't go, second should go. And this intervention was through IT solution, that's called health call center. That time call centers were there only for businesses. So it was the first call center in the government domain also. So I pulled up people from some private sector, they run the call center, and we also have a public-private partnership kind of thing where the doctors from the private sector also have become our members, and they were available on the call. If there is any accident, emergency, they can come and operate. Because as you know, government doctors are a limited number there. In a big, that time, the district was about 16,000 square kilometer, so you can't imagine the size. Now it is in 3 districts. So this was very successful, small innovation I just wanted to share. It costed me only 7 lakh rupees. Unlike now 108 runs about maybe 2,000, 5,000 crores budget and purchases ambulances and deploy, that was only pooling the resources, not on buying the resource. Another one innovation which I would like to share is about the degree online services in Telangana, that is called DOST. Some of you from the government of Telangana here are aware about the DOST initiative. What did we do? What is innovative in that? Innovative is integration of 6 universities and 1200 colleges, 250 courses, 7 mediums. It was there earlier also, but we have pulled up and connected all these 6 universities together. Now we have made the life of the applicant very easy. They can apply online for any course, any college combination. The student even need not give all the details. If they have Aadhaar number, they quote the Aadhaar number, every detail will automatically come. If they do not have, then they have to enter the earlier hall ticket number. That's it. So you fetch all details, made the process very clean and very smooth. For example, we have also innovated red, green and this yellow system, orange system. Green means we need not bother everybody to enter everything and then go to the same process. Small innovation, but it saved a lot of time for students, because green channel means they don't have to bother. Everything is in place and it will be done. They can give their preference choices for college and course combinations. That's it. Red channel means they have to necessarily come to a center where they have to validate their certification. Maybe they are from outside the state, or maybe there is some problem with the certification. Red channel people were very limited. Imagine the degree admissions were such difficult that individual college used to do. Students were not getting admission where they want in a top colleges. On the other hand, other colleges were suffering, not getting the students. Even now, there are so many seats vacant. But imagine when this project started, and now after running for 3 years, there is a remarkable improvement in filling the seats. And particularly in government institution, it is almost more than 90%. It's a great achievement. I mean, this is small intervention again. And we have integrated with the Board of Intermediate Education, that is a backward linkage, forward with the SBTET, MSET, E-Pass, and all these things. As you know, E-Pass is for the scholarships. So those who are getting in through this degree college, they will be automatically routed for the scholarship if they are eligible. So with this kind of steps, you know, these are the small innovations or interventions which are helping the student community here. If you see, the meritorious students get admission to the college of their choice. Good colleges get good number of students now. They don't have to beg somebody. Eliminated the middlemen totally. Avoided duplicate and fake admissions. Increase in admission and government seat, which I told you, and lot of manual efforts and paper cost, turnaround time, everything is saved. You can imagine the kind of impact it is making and kind of inquiries we are generating from other states. This is a unique project. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to tell you, because university in itself, just now we had a vice chancellor of one university here. All universities are independent, and to bring 6 universities together is a big task. In India, we are trying. That's why this is the major problem, not the technology as a problem. It is the systems. So innovation. So coming back to quickly, let us take one eGovernance initiative, because I wanted to share not only eGovernance but eGovernance initiative also. And how does it happen? As you know, e-governance, m-governance, these are all progression. These are all part of governance. So if you see, couple of years back, somebody used to do some kind of intervention, he used to be lauded, and he can present like this, saying that great things are happening. But now, what is happening is people are expecting. Our population is in the age group of youngsters, isn't it? India is very young. And at this age population, the demands are increasing. All of you are expecting, like going to Amazon and buying in no time. You want that kind of service from government, isn't it? So naturally, the citizen wants more and more services on mobile, because mobile is accessible to the rural area. And I think there are about the population equal to number of mobiles. We are reaching that equation in India. There's a huge number. So if that is the case, Mobile services are no more fancy. They are essential. We must give. All governments are mandated to give. And I would like to, this CGG has done so many interventions and so many governance initiatives. I don't want to list and all, they are there. You can just go through that screen, and then one example I will take. Recently we have launched about 6 months back this program called Mana Isuka Vahanam for Government of Telangana. It is now running for 11 districts. The last district is added only 2 days back. So the slide may have 10 districts, but it is 11 districts now. What does it do? It is about the, if you see here, is about sand management. In every district there are sand management societies, and if you want to buy sand for some building construction, you have to go apply and then get a sand delivery. But now with this kind of thing, you can book like Amazon, which I was mentioning. Just take your mobile, and on that app of Mana Isuka Vahanam, if you just say how much sand you need from the combo box and then click a button, immediately a payment gateway comes. You make a payment through any one of the channels, your whether it is a Bheem application, or it is your UPI at the background, or credit, debit, internet, mobile banking, anything. You pay and that's it. Automatically it is queued and you will be delivered sand. You will be notified at each stage when you receive the sand. Like Amazon, you will sign on the mobile so that that tractor is free for the next trip. There is no influence they can create on the district machinery, which earlier there was a chance that they can influence and then say, put my tractor number of times, and somebody else's will not get chance. These are all poor people. The tractor owners are from a humble background and they are very happy. The online booking, as I told you, transparent system, customer can track that OTP or signing on the mobile. Tractor registration is also very easy. Earlier they were not giving registration to these tractor owners easily. Now the unauthorized excavation and transportation also has been curtailed. I was given to understand, I interacted with a couple of SPs of the district, and there is a remarkable improvement. So we have helped into law and order also to some extent, right? But focus is on, this innovation is on the common man. Can they get sand like any other commodity without getting into jargons of government, bribing somebody, requesting someone out of the turn? Nothing. You just book, you demand. So achievements is, within 6 months, the district revenues have gone up to 50%. Can you imagine? The revenues are a single most pointer. That the things are simple, people will lap it. You make it simple, innovative, and that is the theme. Maybe, I don't know, this online procurement management system I'll just cover. This is the last one, and because time will run out. This is, you are aware about the paddy procurement? How many people know about the paddy and procurement system and all? Maybe government. Paddy procurement, when farmers are not getting price for their cultivated paddy, they will go and sell, right, in the market. In that case, what they do is government support them. Government say, I will buy at particular rate. That is called minimum support price, MSP. Now with this MSP implementation, the demand is, you should be in a position to set up the center anywhere where there is a demand to help the farmer. And second one is, farmer should get remuneration with what our honorable CM says, ensure that remuneration should be given to the farmer within 48 hours. Earlier it used to take 15 days. From 15 days to bring it down to 48 hours is a major challenge for civil supplies department. And we are very proud and happy to share that we have brought down to what CM's mandate is. Most of the people get in that range of 2 to 3 days. Some people get in the range of 4 to 5 days. But imagine, from 15 days, the immediate payment system, how that has happened. Because this is a mobile-based solution, tab-based solution. we have given to the procurement centers can be opened anytime. They just carry a tab, they measure the paddy, and then and there receipt is given. Immediate processing has been done online and the payment procedure starts. Immediately, the farmer will get money in his own account. There is no need of going and begging and asking somebody for his own paddy, which unfortunately, I am a witness that many states where I visited, even now this primitive practice is there, that farmers have to wait, sell their paddy and wait for their money. So if you see on the stakeholders' benefit which are listed there, you will get in one go, transparent again, and very much beneficial to farmers, also beneficial to millers. Earlier they were not knowing how much paddy will come. Now millers are benefited, finance department is benefited, district officials, civil supply department, and the quantum, just the outcomes and achievements, 9,500 crore worth paddy is procured from 10 lakh farmers, highest in the country. 3,378 PPCs are operating, that is paddy purchase counters. So these are the figures. Now it is for you to understand how this mobile-based small innovation can help the lives of 21 lakh farmers in this our own state. Ladies and gentlemen, I think I will conclude here about the innovation, e-governance, e-governance. There are many, many such examples. I just wanted to tell in 1-2 minutes, at CGG Center for Good Governance, it is about 18 years back the journey started, and it is founded for making this kind of change in the lives of people, think and give solutions which will work in the field. So we work in the domains of like consultancy, government consultancy called knowledge and research. We work on most of the domains. We have now recently prepared good governance indicators for Government of India, which will be applicable for all the states, which will measure which state is performing better in which kind of indicator. So that Honorable PM will be launching shortly. And we also worked with major ministries, also various state governments. Our e-governance solutions, about at any given point of time we are developing about 100-150 solutions. They are working about 6 states in the country right now. Majority of them we work for Telangana, but we are also working for international organizations like WHO, UNICEF, World Bank and all. So 350 people are there, and we are a CMM level 3 organization adhering to all quality standards, also ISO, and we are also getting shortly ISO 27001, which is the most important for information security. So these are our lot of infrastructure facilities. You can visit anytime, and I encourage the startups and all other people who are here apart from government, you can come visit and look at this. So our clientele which is there on this board, and these are the awards and all. But if you have any questions, I think 5 minutes I can get from Sudhir. I would like to thank Sudhir, Gautam, Elets, Ravi, and all their whole team which has made it possible and invited me for this session today. And it's a wonderful experience to always work with them. We had earlier also on municipal and innovative theme it was there. So I wish them all the success for this conference, which is right now in 2 halls going on, and again merging after lunch, I was given to understand. So if anybody has anything, so this is what I wanted to present. Thank you.